In the reactor hall of the nuclear power plant, the spent nuclear fuel assemblies can be moved between the reactor vessel, the cooling pond, and the service pond by means of the refueling machine. After the cooling period, by use of the refueling machine, the assemblies are loaded in the service pond into a C30 container designed for this purpose. In order to minimize the radiation exposure to the stuff, the lid of the container is put under water. After uplifting the container, its surface is decontaminated from the boric acid of cooling pond origin and placed onto a stamp, so-called pack, where the lid is closed. The water from the container is forced out by compressed air, letting the water to the cooling pond. For cooling purpose, the container is replenished with clean water into such a way that the assemblies are fully covered up and the spare space is filled with nitrogen cushion. The container prepared for the transport is craned to a specially designed railway carriage, which takes the load to the perception building of the interim storage for spent nuclear fuel, locating in the immediate vicinity of the nuclear power plant. Here the container is hoisted with a crane of 100 tons capacity and placed onto a device serving to position it. The nitrogen cushion in the container is let down and the screws are removed from the lid. The container arrives through the transfer corridor under the lid lifting device, where the lid is removed. Then it stops under the drying tube. The grasping device of the refueling machine grips the assembly sitting in the container under the water and transfers it to the drying tube. The assembly is then dried both inside and outside by use of hot air of about 160 Celsius degrees for 1.5 hours. After this, the refueling machine draws the assembly into a lid-shielded cylinder locating within the refueling machine. During the drying operation, the operator removes the cover plate locating above the designated storage tube. The assembly is now ready to be taken to a well-defined storage position. The refueling machine is positioned above the storage tube and begins the emplacement operation. With the help of the plug remover device, it takes the shielding plug off, and by turning the so-called tower, comprising the spent fuel assembly as well, the assembly is rotated above the storage tube. The refueling machine inserts the assembly, then rotates the shielding plug above the storage tube, finally replaces it and seals the tube. The operator, by use of a special device, pumps the air out of the storing tube via a filling unloading valve, providing a pressure inside the tube close to the absolute vacuum. Using the same valve, the operator then fills the storage tube with high purity nitrogen, creating a slight overpressure. This oxygen-free, nitrogen-fraught environment ensures the corrosion-free condition for the fuel assembly. The operator makes sure of the tightness of the shielding plug and by reinstalling of the cover plate finishes the emplacement operation. The tubes are being cooled from outside by the air passing through the storage vault. Since the air circulation is ensured by natural draught, the assemblies are never remained without cooling.